What's up, guys? Welcome back to Choco, back to another video. And in today's video, we're pretty much gonna be doing a full CIC conversion. We're going from non-iDrive, the single hump, to the dual hump. Now, some people actually wanna do this, some people don't wanna do this. The people that don't wanna do this, you can just click off this video because this is not gonna be satisfying for you guys. But for those of you guys who are ready to actually have a navigation in your car, you can install backup camera, Apple CarPlay, all that good stuff. Not from this direct install, this install will just get you the basic CIC conversion. But if you guys wanna install backup camera and Apple CarPlay, there will be a future video on that here to come. But in the meantime, guys, we do have the CIC unit. We got this actually from a pick and pull yard. So actually I got this dashboard for little to nothing. Same goes for the CIC unit. It actually comes with the heated seat buttons, the bracket right here. We got a new bracket from BMW right here. We have the AC climate control, trim and climate control. Technically you just need the trim, but since it was a pick and pull car, buying the trim and buying the whole thing is the same price. We just picked up this entire thing. We need this cable that goes from the screen to the CIC unit itself. And then we have the USB port, which we'll need to update it, if anything. And this is the K-CAN cable. Again, if we're gonna need to do any updates and stuff like that, code it to the VIN, we'll do that in the end. Technically, this isn't really necessary. Now, will this work without getting anything coded? Yes. But will it work properly? No. You guys won't have the navigation feature, probably have a couple things that just don't match with your car. So getting it VIN matched is the way to do it. But yeah, again, this will work and at least you can play music and stuff like that and have a screen. It looks dope without the coding. This is the iDrive controller with the trim we ended up picking up as well. And then we got a CIC screen right here. So this is all you really need. Again, you can just get this all from a pick and pull if you're lucky to find this. I mean, this stuff gets, you know, picked up and resold on eBay all the time, but if you can get a good deal, this is the way to go. I think all this stuff cost me maybe like $200-$300. So yeah, that's a pretty good deal. You will need a custom harness. It does need the harness so you can just get everything tapped in, have proper power for everything. I am now actually supplying those harnesses on my website, link down below. So if you guys wanna get that harness, it's gonna be direct plug and play, or you guys can honestly just try, you know, tapping in wires everywhere. It's not gonna look as clean as the harness. So if you guys wanna get the harness, again, link down below to make your lives so much easier. But without further ado, let's go ahead and disconnect the battery, move the seats all the way back to make your lives easy, make it to where you can remove everything super easily. We're disconnecting the battery because we have airbags we have to disconnect. So we don't want airbags blowing in our faces. So first things first, guys, let's get that battery disconnected. So now that we have the battery disconnected, guys, we can literally just jump into the interior and just start taking all this stuff apart. First things I like to do, honestly, is just move all the things that make life easy, like all the trim pieces, and then probably the center stuff, steering wheel, stuff like that. And then we'll start getting into like the actual cluster and stuff behind it. But actually, do we need to remove the center console first?
That's what I like to do first.
Okay, that's so. What he likes. I think that's actually the best way to go about it. Ooh, bro, you didn't have to put it even in gear to do that. Okay, well, that looks like obviously this is not Nick's first time.
Probably my third or fourth.
So, yeah, he's just going to go ahead and remove this trim piece, all that stuff, just to expose the screws that are going to be needed to remove the actual center console.
Out. So for your passenger side airbag, there's two connectors. That's one stage and that's another stage. So we're gonna make it a little flathead and carefully pry them out.
So Nick just went ahead and disconnected the airbag. We are 100% now done on this side. We disconnected the A-pillar and everything. So at this point, we're gonna come around to this side, remove this A-pillar, remove the steering wheel, the cluster, all the screws to the dash. And then after that, literally the dash should just come out since we have the center console out.
Get our hand in there and gently make sure these clips come out. Don't break the tabs. We got one more there. Yep, perfect.
And guys, we are at the point, we have the dash out of the car. This is the harness we're gonna need. We're gonna show you guys how you actually use this harness. This harness makes the job pretty much a plug and play kit. You guys don't have to plug in a bunch of random wires everywhere and finick with everything. This literally plugs in directly into your screen and this one plugs directly into your controller. This will go into the fuse box. It's a fuse tap. You guys don't have to do anything else after that. And then these three wires, I'll show you guys exactly where to pin them. And then bam, bada bing, bada bing. That's how you get a full navigation system to work. If you guys wanna get this harness, link's gonna be down below. We are gonna go ahead and show you guys how, when I say we, I mean Nick, how to install this bad boy. So now that we're back in the car, guys, Nick's gonna go ahead and show you guys where we actually route the harness. So that is the display cable, right?
Correct. This is the display power connector. And then this is the connector we're eventually gonna pin everything into. So we're just gonna quick loosely route this into the car. Down through up this dash and we'll over again and we're gonna leave it in between your blower motor and your dash bar. We're just gonna loosely run
the controller harness
which is gonna run to here, but before we do anything, we're gonna want to make sure we pin this in. Basically, we're gonna be pinning in to this black connector on your fuse box and your junction box. So we're just gonna disconnect this. Then there's two little tabs we need to press, either with a tool or your fingernails, and slide that off. And then slide these two connectors out. Each side of this connector is labeled. So this side, that's pin slot 1, that's 18. The other side of this is pin slot 19 and 36. And then this little extension or separate connector inside this main connector is 37 to 54. We're not gonna be pinning anything into this connector. We're only gonna be pinning into this main black connector. So the first wire we need to pin is pin slot 11. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So in between this orange and green wire, we're gonna be pinning in the orange wire in the harness. So move the wires out a bit to give you some room, and we're just going to slide that in. Hear the click, that is now installed. Then on the other side, we're going to be pinning this green into pin slot 30, so 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So in between this orange wire and this green wire, we're gonna be pinning in this green wire as well. Slide that in, hear the little click. That is now installed. And then we have one more wire. This is our ground. This is gonna go into pin slot 27, so that was 30, 29, 28, 27. Gonna slide that to pin slot 27. You're all done there. Now we gotta take this, slide this back in.
So once Nick actually slides those two pieces together, he's gonna put the cover right back on it. Mm-hmm. And then literally after that, we're gonna go ahead and connect that back to the car. And we'll literally have two OEM plugs, one that literally just goes directly to the screen and one directly into the controller, as if, you know, your car came equipped with it. So that's what the harness pretty much does. All right, guys, so now that we have this connector back in there, part of the harness is the fuse tap, so you can actually draw safe power. We're gonna be tapping this. This is an LCI. If you have a 2008 or up, you're gonna be tapping this into fuse 76. If you have a 2006 or 7, do you know which one that would go into?
It would vary by car.
Vary by car. Okay, so you have to check your fuse diagram for something like that. But for this car, again, 2008 and up, you would just tap that into fuse 76. You're gonna be pulling that out right now. Typically, you should have a fuse tap tool. It should come in there. It should actually sit right over here. This car doesn't have it, so we had to use some pliers. But yeah, don't never. Be. Mm-hmm. You gotta do what you gotta do, you know?
But anyway, we're gonna put our factory fuse into this slot. Make sure it's pressed in all the way. And then we're gonna take our fuse tap.
And just plug it right back in there.
Plug it right in there.
So that's how it's gonna look, guys. Again, when we took out that fuse 76, we put it right back onto the fuse tap and then put it right in there to fuse 76. And that is it, guys. So at this point, yeah, you only have two connectors to the screen, to the controller. So we can just start honestly reassembling everything at this point.
Pretty much.
At this point, guys, we are ready to install the dashboard. We got the connector right here and the other connector that you would have never had for the controller screen. Let's do it, guys. Let's go ahead and throw this dashboard in there and make this a reality. So in our case, guys, when I actually picked up this dashboard, that dashboard actually had an airbag in it. I didn't disconnect the airbag, so I have an airbag in that. If you guys did not get an airbag on your new dashboard, make sure you just disconnect it from here. It's just held on by a couple screws right there and right over here, and then just transfer your airbag to your new dashboard. Since again, we have an airbag in this dashboard, we can just skip that step entirely. So what we're doing now, guys, as we're installing the dashboard, we're not just putting the dashboard in, we're trying to pull the wires out. So once the dashboard's actually in there, we can actually connect everything properly, and the dashboard's not actually blocking any of the wires, because yeah, you don't want that happening and putting in all the bolts and then you forget to actually pull out one of the harness wires. So now, guys, now that we have all the wires routed where we want to route them, we have the display cable right here. We got these wires routed right here. We have the buttons and all that good stuff routed. The cluster, we checked right over there. Everything's good. At this point, we're going to go ahead and start installing all the screws. You put in one right there. I believe there is one in the middle.
Here.
So we're just, again, we're putting all these screws in right now just to kind of hold the dash in place so we can start assembling everything. Don't forget about these screws or your dash is going to be vibrating when you're driving. There's another one right over here, guys. And don't forget this side bolt right here that attaches the little metal bracket to the dashboard. So one right there, one right here, one right there, one right there. And there's actually one down there and there's one down here.
And all these screws are pretty much the same size except these two, but they go there and there are a little bit longer.
We'll be right back. Guys, we are installing the first piece to this retrofit, which is the screen. And we're also gonna be installing the cable as well to the screen. I'm gonna be routing it downwards to the CIC unit. So yeah, that is Nick directing it downward. Oof, look at that harness. Direct plug and play, guys. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, buddy, guys, no iDrive to iDrive, not even your typical CCC, CIC. This is gonna look so good. Hold that up there. Oof. Now this USB, is it required for this install or no?
To code, like if you're coding your unit fully in the car, you do need a USB port. Okay. You can also use to update your maps in the future, and then you can also load music onto the CIC's hard drive. So it is kind of an expensive, like that's $50 and that's like $40 for the cable, but you know, it makes it a complete OEM retrofit.
But yeah, like what Nick said, guys, with that USB port, if you guys have that, you'll be able to code this thing, always update it, use all the functions. But if you don't have it, you don't have to have it. You can still end up, the CIC should still load up. You can still listen to music, listen to all the good stuff, but you're not gonna be able to use all the features on here without that, because you're gonna need to update it.
Wire that will tap into the factory, either pre-wiring or your TCU, which would be right there, would have a GPS connector, and we're gonna try to squeeze the cable through there instead of having to take all this bit off, but I think we'll be able to get it done.
Okay, guys, if you guys don't have folding seats like this car does, you pretty much just route the wire right underneath the seat. All that Nick pretty much did is pop off the rear seats and just literally tuck the wire right underneath this, straight into the trunk. And now we're gonna be able to plug it into the stock factory harness right there to the back, which is gonna allow us to have navigation. And then we're gonna go ahead and route that wire underneath the seat and plug it into our new CIC unit. And part of the conversion, guys, you're gonna need a new trim piece to hold your iDrive controller. Your old center console trim was gonna have a little storage here. It doesn't actually have the iDrive cutout, so you will have to get a new trim piece. This one already has the iDrive controller, so let's just go ahead and just install it and just plug that bad boy into the harness, and it's gonna look so good, guys. Finally, guys, it is time to install the CIC system right now, guys. And that, guys, is what I'm talking about. This looks so good. Obviously, it needs a lot of cleaning, but after connecting the battery, we got some power, guys. We should actually be seeing something on the screen pretty soon. I mean, again, we haven't done any coding yet. We just installed everything with the plug-and-play harness, so moment of truth. That's what I'm talking about, guys. We got the CIC. As you guys can see, everything's lighting up, even on the iDrive controller. Everything is how it should be OEM with this harness. Oh my God, that looks so good, bro. So the navigation function, that's what I was talking about earlier, guys. That's grayed out because that's something that needs to be coded, but like everything else should work properly.